Welcome back to the Plan Development Workflow video series for FDOT Connect. In this chapter, we're going to go over our labeling. So we're going to get into a little bit of plan labels, profile labels, and cross-section labels. So this chapter is going to introduce the new way of placing notes using the Place Label tool. The Place Label tool has replaced the Plan View Labeler tool that was previously found in Geopack. So let's get started. So I've gone ahead and opened up my FDOT Connect for OpenRoads Designer software by using the icon on our desktop. And I've also gone ahead and opened my PlanRD labeling file. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go over just how to lay out a few labels that we've got set up. So I'm in my sheet model right now, but I want to switch over to my drawing model. And just for the purposes of this training guide and this video, we are going to go ahead and place our labels in the drawing model. However, with your project, there's a few places you can do them. You can do them in the drawing model. You can do them in the design model of your plan files. Or you can also still use the text file. So once you cut your sheets, you would just reference that into your text file, and you can place the labels in the text file as well. So I'm in my drawing model, and what I want to do is I want to go back to my home tab and make sure I set my text level first. So I'll grab my text label level. And then what I want to do is I want to switch over to drawing production. And the new tool we're going to be looking at is this Place Label tool. So I'll just launch that. And so there's two different types of labels using this tool. What we've done is we've set up text favorites. So I'm going to switch my type to text favorite. And then also what we've done, just kind of for ease, of finding all the labels, we've added underscore prefixes to our labels. So we've got underscore PL, we've got underscore PR, and then the other one we're going to hit on is underscore XS. And so that's for your plan, profile, and then also your cross-section labels. So the first one we're going to label is our begin project. So let me find my underscore PL begin project. And I also want to make sure I set my dimension style. So we're going to use our FDOT dynamic labels. And then now what it's asking me for is what do I want to track off of to place these labels? So these are civil intelligent labels that we're placing. So they'll read off of our alignments, or they'll read off of any civil elements that have intelligence to them as well. So what I want to do is I want to select my baseline 98. And so it's got it highlighted. So now that's the one, that's the element that we're tracking off of for our labels. So now what I'll do is I'll left click where I want the actual terminator to go. So I'm just going to place it right here. And then if you'll notice, it's now got my label template is showing. And until you actually place these labels in the file, it's just going to have the default zeros there. But once I actually place it, and I'll left click to place, then I'll get my civil intelligence information right there. So we've got our station 31 plus 7101. And the next label that we're going to place is going to be our begin construction. And so again, we just come over to our dialog, and let me just switch my favorite. So I'll grab my PL begin construction. And if you'll notice, the alignment is still highlighted. So I can place multiple labels if I just need to switch favorites or anything along the same alignment, and I don't have to select that alignment every time. So I'll just zoom out a little bit and come to a different area. And so we'll just place this label, just place it anywhere out in space. And then again, just kind of drag where you want the label to be and left click to place. And then the final example we're going to show is our station offset. So we've actually got a couple station offsets set up for plan. If I scroll down in my list, I've got station offset full, and I've also got station offset partial. So I'm just going to grab my station offset partial. And this time I'll just place it on my pavement milling line right here, just for an example. So I'll click on there. And so I've got my station, and it's got my offset off of the alignment. And it'll also place, depending upon left or right of the alignment, you'll get the appropriate indicator there as well. So that covers the plan labeling, which is exercise 11.1. So next we'll go ahead and jump into our profile labeling file, and then we'll get into some profile labels. So exercise 11.2 covers our profile labeling. So I've gone ahead and opened up my profile labeling file. And so with the plan labeling, as I said earlier, you can label in your drawing model, you can do it in your design model, or you can do your text file as well. That's not going to be the case with profile labels. So any profile labeling is going to have to actually be done within the drawing model for that sheet. So we've got our sheet cut, and I've already opened up my drawing model for this one. So what we're going to do is I'm going to switch to my home tab and set my level. And again, we're going to grab our text label level. And then once we set that, again, we'll go ahead and jump back to drawing production, and we'll grab our place label tool. And so it remembers some of the stuff from the previous file and the last time that the tool is run. So it's got my type already set for me for the text favorite, and it remembers the last favorite that we used also. So but since we're in profile, what I want to do is I want to grab my underscore PR. And so for this one, we're going to take a look at our PR begin profile. So, and again, we want to set our dimension style to F. Dynamic labels. And then I'll just zoom in here. And again, similar to the plans, what you'll do is you'll select your element that you're going to be labeling off of. So I've gone ahead and selected my profile. So now I'll just come down here into space. And for this one, I'll actually select on my profile. So I'll just snap to this location right here, left click, and then I'll just drag this down a little bit to place it. And so we've got our begin profile, station, and that station is actually being read from our profile. So just the next example we're going to throw on there is going to be our begin milling and resurfacing. So I'll come back to my favorites. And so right here, we've got our underscore PR begin milling resurfacing. So you may have your profile start prior to where you're actually going to be doing some of your work, the construction work on there. So we've got our begin set up here. And let's say we're just going to start our actual mill and resurface a little bit further in. So I'll just select right there. And again, I'll just kind of bring this up and just find a place where I can place it cleanly in there. So left click to place. And again, it's pulling my station from the actual alignment. And then one more we're going to throw on here, and I'll just come down here towards the end of my profile. Got begin widening. So I'll grab my PR begin widening. And I'll just select my profile again. Left click. And then left click to place it again. So that's just the examples on how to come in and place some labels on your profile that aren't that aren't being labeled with our profile annotation that we also have set up. So that's exercise 11.2. Next, we're going to get into 11.3, and we'll place a few cross-section labels. So exercise 11.3 is our labeling cross-sections. So I've gone ahead and opened up my cross-section labeling file. And what I want to do is I want to switch to, so I've already got my drawing model open. So, and again, just like with the profile, any labels that we do are going to have to be done in the actual drawing model. So the plan labels are the only ones that you can have, that you can label, that you have the choice of where you might want to label. So I'm in my drawing model. And again, what we want to do is we want to use our place label tool. So, but before I do that, I want to make sure I switch to my home tab and set my level. So again, we're going to look for our text label level. All right, and then I'll go back to my drawing production and I'll launch my place label tool. So what we're going to have to do is I'm going to have to set my type here, because again, we only set up text favorites for these. So we do only have a few for the cross sections. So we're just going to demonstrate a couple of labels on the cross sections. So I'll select my favorite, and these are going to be under the underscore XS. So we'll do a cross section elevation. And then I also want to make sure I set my dimension style for FDOT dynamic labels. And so with this one, we don't have to grab an alignment, unlike with the plan and the profile ones, we can track off of an alignment. But with this one, all we actually need to do is just go ahead and place our label anywhere in here, because it's already, these are set up to read from your terrain already. So with this one, I'm just going to go ahead and select this fill graphic right here and left click to start. And then I'll left click again to place the label in there. So the next one I want to show is going to be our offset elevation as well. So I'll set my text favorite to XS offset elevation. And so now I'll come over here and I'll grab the top of this curve right here, and I'll just place it right here. So, and then left click to place. And again, depending on which side of the alignment you're on, you'll get your either your LT or your RT. And I'll just come over to the curve on my left side just to demonstrate that. And then there we go. So that's just the overview on placing labels in your cross section. And so that's going to go ahead and conclude chapter 11, as well as the training guide for our FDOT Connect plan development workflows. And once again, I'd just like to thank you for joining me for this video on the chapter 11 labeling, and also just for checking out the entire video series for the FDOT Connect plan development workflow. Be sure to check out the rest of our training through the FDOT CAD training link right there on the screen. And then also send any support questions you may have to our CAD support email.